Hello, in the last video about my Twisty Puzzle chess set, I sculptured part of the knight, made a mould of it, and then cast this second generation master. I now need a mirror image of it also. Unfortunately, in the real world, I can't simply copy, paste, and flip to make it. First, I need to modify the 3D printed frame in a similar fashion to before. So now for the sculpting. I can use this reflection to help me, though a lot of it would be done with the parts temporarily assembled. I'm so glad I devised this technique, since it makes things so much easier than they could have been. Imagine sculpting the horse's head and then cutting it accurately into four without doing any damage to it. That's how I initially thought I would have to do it. Let's have some moves it while I do this work, and then I'll talk some more later. The music was The Future Ancient Now by Nathan Moore. Sculpting the other side of the head took about half the time of the first. It's now finished and I can carefully remove it. The eyes, by the way, are leftover screw ball bearings from my old projects. A little tidying up was required, but I can add the universal middle and make a mold and silicon rubber. Once set, the sculpture is removed and I can use the mold to cast the second generation master in smooth-on Task 2 polyurethane resin. This of course is much more durable than the plasticine, plus I can sand it to make it smoother. I'm poking wire into the ears because this is where air bubbles formed in the other side's castings. The resin is now set and ready to be removed. See how the ear is okay, whereas the first half had a bit missing where an air bubble got trapped. I'm using wet and dry sandpaper to make it smoother before using a part to make the final mould. My design means the throat and chest of the horse are very simple and easy to sculpt. I still need to make moulds of the two parts of Kuss and cast second generation masters. The rubber is set so the parts can be removed. Now for the smooth-on Task 2 polyurethane resin. Plastic sheet on the top to make sure it remains perfectly flat and the right dimensions. The resin is set and ready to be removed. After some sanding, a quick check to see everything lines up correctly. Before I make the final set of night moulds, I need to repair the ear of the first piece I cast. I'm using Milliput, which is a two-part epoxy putty that sets like resin, though not as hard. Once set, I can sand it to make it smoother. With all four parts of the night's top done, I'm ready to make the final moulds for casting the actual chest pieces. As you have probably realised by now, this puzzle making technique involves an awful amount of mould making and casting. I still find it far more satisfying than just 3D printing everything though. The rubber has set so I can remove the second generation masters. Now for the casting with the Burson 26 polyurethane resin. Resin is set and ready for removal. The parts look fine, though we'll need some minor tidying up and filling before they are attached onto the 2x2 core. As usual, I am using Loctite superglue gel. I've squeezed some onto a piece of glass and using a needle to accurately place it where needed. As with the King, the placement of the parts onto the 2x2 must be perfect. A horse that doesn't line up with itself would look awful, whereas a pawn, for example, isn't quite as important. I am unhappy about leaving the bright colours on the 2x2 as they would be visible during some moves. However, I have never managed to dye this kind of plastic and painting just makes a puzzle this size stiff. So I have no option but to just leave it. Some more casting and assembly and I have both white knights finished. Now for a test and a solve. Movement seems okay, there's no clashing. And it's important that I got the pieces like very close together, otherwise it's going to just look wrong with a big gap. And there's always a danger because when you do that, or when you sort of make those moves, it's going to like hit each other. Let's just scramble it. It's kind of weird seeing it like that. Obviously these pieces will be covered up with the material. See if there's any other sort of weird kind of way I can make it. Okay. Right, so let's go for a solve. Although actually, just before I do that, I'll just show you the like the obvious blocking type situation, which is the same on some of the pawns and also the bishop. Right, enough of that, and just put those pieces together. Because these pieces are very similar, so they're not, it's not obvious where they go, although I know actually that curve piece goes there. But if you're solving it for the first time, or you don't, if you don't know the puzzle, you wouldn't know that. Right, so that's the top part done, and just two of the corners need orientating. It's a little awkward with the pieces sticking out. See, that's when you get an issue, because I can't complete the move how I wanted it to. And now I've kind of completely lost where I was. Maybe I'll go around the other way. I think we'd have to start again. I'm just going to see what happens if I put this other, put this bottom into place. You never know, it might sort of come up nice. Now things are getting a bit weird. Now I've kind of got to start again. I think out of all of these I've tried so far, that's the first time I've actually kind of got on a muddle with something. Because obviously they're only 2x2, so they're pretty easy, but that completely threw me off. So let's try this again. So I've got to orientate that piece and orientate that piece. Trying to keep track of where I am in case that same thing happens again. Right, so I think I'm going to be okay this time. This isn't, these aren't clashing, it's just that it's awkward to hold. That's if it looks as if it's kind of a bit weird. Right, so that's solved. A little bit trickier than I expected, but at least it shows us sort of the clashing element works.
With a full set of white pieces done, you may be expecting me to crack open a champagne. If you've watched every video though, you will understand why I am not. In the next video, I will rectify every issue with these pieces and present a Twisty Puzzle chess set I can truly be proud of. Well, hopefully.